here for a minute. Bet you want a girl to keep it independent. And I know you gotta like a girl that's disappearing. Get you caught up in the moment, then I'll get you in your feelings. Tell your boys that you gon' meet them later on. Both of us are so taxi, leave the meter on. First time you out in Cali, never tried no that strong, so you gon' have some stories to tell when you take your back home. And tell them one time, Snowy always showed you what it's like. Leave you sleepy like the call the umpire. Get you out and get you rolling, get you. Gotta go, I got a flight up in the morning. On
hello everyone, I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. Going back to last week, the result of their game might not have turned out the way this guy would have liked, but he did have a decent effort in the secondary in the loss. Maybe he can step his game up a notch or two this week and help get him a win. It's the Steelers going up against the Dolphins. With that, let's head on down to Miami.
Tannehill. He's got time in the pocket. And incomplete to open things up. Keyshawn Martin's the one he was looking for. And it's second down. So we'll look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. And they tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you know you've drafted well, scouted free agents well, and stocked your team just the way you're supposed to. When the hitch route is run really well, that jab step off the line of scrimmage by the receiver, which is designed to back up the defender and give him a little bit of space, all you want there, get that space, catch the football, and then make a move and pick up extra yardage, and that's exactly what he got done there.
They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And he'll get this up to about the 40. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Again, it's Williams. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
Stephon Tuitt came out of Notre Dame as another one of those really tall defensive ends, and you just wonder, would they be able to have the leverage to bend and make plays? I think he just gave us an answer with that tackle.
And that is incomplete. So on fourth down, here's Matt Darr to kick it away. He's going to go ahead and field it from the 3-yard line. 21 yards. Well done on the return. And out will come the offense as they take over. Down throw, Tannehill. This complete to Martin. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. It's a 4-yard pickup, and it'll bring up a second down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
On second down, Williams. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. And the offense lining up first and 10.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
Here's Tannehill. And they showed a little athletic juke, but then the daylight quickly closed. It's a gain of 5, and that'll bring up second down. 5 yards left for the offense. It's second down. Back to throw, Tannehill. He's got time. Letting one go deep for the end zone. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
And right now I take my rudimentary kindergarten skills and draw where the tackle box would be, because that was close. I thought he was in the tackle box. He has to be very careful where he gets rid of the football from that spot.
Yeah, they say there was a receiver in the area, though.
Yeah. There's always a receiver in the area. But, partner, anytime someone tells me that fundamentals are...
Here's Franks now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And an alley to run.
And that's the type of return that puts a tremendous amount of pressure on the defense now. They've got to go out on the field almost like it's a sudden change, almost like it's a turnover. They've got to go out there and try and stop them. But, boy, what a tough spot they're in.
The Steelers' offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And Tannehill on first down, finding time, and now he lost the football. Tannehill loses it.
On plays like this, when the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from it. In this case,
back now with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter begins with the Dolphins in possession of the football, but they face a second and long to start things out. They run it again with Williams. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. James Harrison, the veteran, in on the stop.
After watching that play and result, I go back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator, Brandon, before the game and said, how are you going to move the ball running it against the number one defense? He gave us no indication, didn't tip his hand at all.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football, and it's picked up by the Steelers. And they will have the football deep in enemy territory all the way. They begin the drive with Williams. And some room to roam now. And he's brought down. It's a pickup of 14 there. And that's good for a Miami first down. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground.
How many times do we say in this game is speed kills? And it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice game.
On second down, here's Tannehill. That is incomplete.
Holding offense.
Yeah, that right there will set him back a bit on the offensive holding penalty.
And you know who you want to pressure after a penalty like that? the guy who just committed the foul. You want to see if he's going to keep his head down or if he's going to get his head right back into the game. I'd send a blitz at him right away and see if he holds up.
Following the penalty, it's Williams. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. A sizable gain there of 9 yards, but it's still third and long.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved them and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
Third and long, it's Tannehill. Surveying the field. On the left side, this is Stills. A gain of 4 on the play, and that'll bring up 4th down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. This is taken at the 18. 39-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And the offense will take over. And the Dolphins getting set to go here. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
The sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
Offside. Defense.
And after a nice gain, they don't need the penalty. They'll decline it, take the ball where the play resulted. And they're going to speed things up here. On first and 10, Tannehill. And he checks this one down to Williams. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
Now Tannehill, he's got time in the pocket. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. And the offense in that middle ground here on third down, 5 yards to go. Tannehill throwing again. He's got time. And he finds Stills, complete. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. On first down, Tannehill finding time. And he's going to drop this off to Williams, complete. They'll give him 8 on the play, and that'll make it a 2nd down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Again, Tannehill, and that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
The Steelers insert their nickel defense on third down.
Yeah, they add a DB. To the air again, Tannehill. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
It doesn't even get there. Well short, and this score will stay right where it is. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. That's fielded in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. So here are the Dolphins now. They get ready for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like at the half?
Because tell me.
That's exactly what they printed up. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker boards?
Yeah, those two.
Now a handoff. Here's Williams trying to run inside, but nothing there. He'll pick up only a yard there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 7.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Now it's Tannehill. He's going to float this one deep right side. It's caught inside the 25. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Leon Snell on to kick it away after the touchdown. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Dolphins offense now working their way back onto the field. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, gave up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. They go play action here. And the Steeler pressured too much here. He's going down. The 38-year-old veteran, how does he do it? James Harrison in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. On 2nd down, here's Tannehill. And it's complete to Martin. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and it'll be 3rd down.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible. Hope he's got man-to-man coverage, and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
To throw is Tannehill, and he's got him. It's the tight end, Cameron. A gain of 11 and a 1st down.
It went full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key 1st down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab. Back now in Miami. It's Dolphin football, but they trail here as we get set for the 4th. On 1st down, it's Tannehill. They'll set up the screen. This is Williams. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46.
You know the key to a good screen pass is, don't you?
Bet you're going to tell me. Good blocking?
Well, good blocking eventually. But first is good acting. You want to let the defenders go past you, leak out to whichever side or even in the middle where you want to set up the screen, and then you do your blocking. How about the read, though, by the defensive guys? They weren't fooled at all and actually ran with the lineman to where the play was and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
And a nifty little deep juke spin move. Not a great deal there on the back end, but a nice game still.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
And he's able to get the 1st here as he's taken down at the 25. And a 2-score game, obviously, every play, every 3rd down, like we saw there, magnified, big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to 3rd down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
And a scary incompletion, almost picked off. It would have been their 1st INT of the game. Instead, 2nd down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
To the air, Tannehill on second down. Looking for Stills here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Ryan Shazier. And they're going to take over right there at the... And out come the Dolphins now. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. Back to throw, Tannehill, and he's going to drop this off to Williams, complete. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. And now they're in the hurry-up.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. No, he almost had it. Already with one interception, just missing his second there. Well, he just threw an interception last drive, nearly another pick.
And things aren't very even right now, are they? It's a little bit sloppy out there, isn't it? It's kind of different driving on those paved roads. And those country roads that have those potholes in them, isn't it? That's the way this game's going right now. A lot of bouncity bounce to it.
You spent some time on some Tennessee country roads.
I certainly have. Plenty of family back there. God love them.
And quickly, they get to the line. Tannehill on first down. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. Damian Williams, the man he was looking for. And that'll bring up second down. Second and 10, Tannehill once more, surveying the field. And it's caught right at the 10-yard line. And he carries this one all the way down to the 9. Great patience in the pocket. Of course, it's easy to be patient when the protection's good, and it was.
Yeah, you got to pat those guys on the helmet and say thanks because they gave him plenty of time to stay back there, survey the field, go through the reads that he wanted to, and deliver the ball accurately. That was really well executed. All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense, but in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. Batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass, excellent job, way to knock it down.
False start, offense.
Again, Tannehill. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. Call it a gain of 5, and that'll make it third and goal. An extra defensive back on the field here for third and goal. And Stills has got it. Touchdown, Miami. Kenny Stills, his first touchdown on the year. Franks now on to kick it away after the touchdown. Wheaton will return it. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. A road win in the National Football League.
Turn up, turn up, turn up. I'm breaking in. I'm at the pearly gates, but they won't let it in. I told the devil, I said, f*** him, I ain't trying to sin. Yeah, I ain't trying to sin.